you all for joining. We're now ready for questions. Okay, guys, we're now out of time. Thank you very much for attending. Apologies if you are unable to get a question in.
It is a great fixture with a wonderful history, and the fans are getting to fever pitch. Moments away, and it's live. The setting is Wembley Stadium, perfect for this occasion. Martin Tyler here with you as usual, and I'm delighted to say I'm joined, as always, by Alan Smith. It's Community Shield Day. It's Newcastle United against Manchester United.
This occasion has thrown up some really good spectacles in the past. I'm hoping for the same here. Two teams that have enjoyed good pre-seasons.
Newcastle United's lineup. It does look more like 4-4-1-1 than 4-4-2.
Yes, I think so. I mean, it gives the manager the option of stiffening his midfield. And when they get the ball, you know, that number 10, if that's what you want to call him, behind the centre forward, he can supply the bullets, he can get in the box and give his teammates some company.
Thank you for attending Wembley Stadium.
This is then the Manchester United lineup. David De Gea starts in goal. Clement Longley starts with Andreas Christensen as the centre-backs. Only one up front in terms of an out-and-out forward. It's the kick-off and it's Newcastle United who are on the ball. Working the opposition over a little bit here with their passing. It's a shot! The right kind of football dive to turn the shot away. He's put in the corner. Punched away by the goalkeeper. Oh, we hit it well enough.
But as we can see, now it's United's free kick.
The yellow card's coming out He knew it was a booking, and now he's shown him the yellow.
It was one of those, was on the borderline. I think he's a bit unlucky, perhaps, to get booked for that.
Jovic, good vision. It's very well cut out at an important time. Whoever's going to win the FA Community Shield is going to have to prove their point in the second half. It's level pegging at half-time.
Yeah, two teams that know each other extremely well, and a bit of a lack of an edge, actually, to it so far.
Having Wolfsburg, that deal is completed.
Well, they are a club that's trying to go...
trying to steer it through. Oh, well saved! And here comes the corner. Gets it away from the goal with a punch here. Sandro. Can put them in front here. And the goalkeeper's out. And he's got to the ball at the feet. Fernandez. Good reading of the play, anticipating the pass. Shot on! Can't get the shot through, good block. And Manchester United are going to make a substitution here. Added on by the referee. If Manchester United are going to win this game, they've got to get a goal now. I think the cross is on. Well, it is a chance to relieve. Well, there's only one way now to sort out between these two teams, and it is a penalty shooter. Is ready to go. Beat the goalkeeper well in this penalty shootout. Up he comes for the penalty. Off target with the penalty.
Well, you look at his run-up and even that looked wrong. It was a poor effort.
Superb from De Gea. Here's the next penalty taker. A save by the goalkeeper. Great chance, and he's wasted it. It's time to step up. All you need to do is put it in the net in the shootout, and he's done it. Well, he scored. No problem.
So next up to take the penalty.
And the goalkeeper has done well to stop that one. Well, he knows now. One successful shot, and they've won it. The pressure was on, but he was up to the task, and they won the shootout.
Well, they picked one of the most experienced men there, and it's paid off.
It's a fine fixture with a lot of history. It was the Charity Shield, now the Community Shield, and this team have won it, and won it well.
They have won it well. They've played some good football, and if they can take that through to the main part of the season, they're going to be a real threat.
Well, these are the photos that the players will treasure for the family albums, and of course they'll be all over the newspapers tomorrow. Well played, and they've certainly done the business today.
Just a couple of questions for you. Thanks, that'll be all for today.
Okay, welcome everyone, thanks for coming. We're going to start with questions now. Guys, we're now out of time. Thanks for attending. Apologies if you were unable to ask your question.
Welcome to you to Villa Park, the home of Aston Villa Football Club in Birmingham, big city in the middle of England. Martin Tyler here, along with Alan Smith. Premier League football right at the start of the brand new season for both these teams. Aston Villa against Newcastle United.
Well, so much hope for both clubs before a ball has been kicked. Nobody's made a mistake yet, and as a player, you just want to get off to a good start. Hopefully a winning one.
Aston Villa team for this game, 4-3-3, and they've got natural wide players in that front three with a central striker.
I think that's the key, because those lads on the flanks, it's quite a complicated job actually, because they've got to come inside, support the centre forward, and they've also got to funnel back when they haven't got the ball, so an onus on them.
Newcastle United's lineup. One main striker, one probably just off it. How are they going to find attacking routes with this formation?
Well, whether they can create through the middle, we'll wait and see. I just think today those two wide lads in midfield are going to be important. Both got a bit of pace, capable of getting around the outside.
Thank you, Villa Park. Enjoy the match.
A lot of anticipation about this game. Aston Villa have got it going in the first half. And the shot go of the keeper, back into play. So that means it's a corner now. He's put in the corner, punches it away. It's gone out for a throw. By the referee now, Jovic. It's good work here in terms of possession. Can they find the final pass? Well, this is an opportunity. When you concede a free kick in an area like this, you could be in serious trouble.
I've just got a feeling this could be a key moment in the match, a great chance to take the lead.
It's half time, and the score is 0-0 here. Not quite good enough so far, Alan.
Well, the opposition will just be hoping that these kind of stats continue, because one of the chief danger men has been shackled really well.
San Maxima. Here's a chance to whip it in. Closed him down well, the cross doesn't come in, good defending. And that advantage is given to Aston Villa. Well, after a lot of media hype and speculation about this deal, Alan, it's finally gone ahead.
Yeah, for me.
A great chance to go in front, but he's missed it. Incredible.
Well, he can't believe it. His teammates can't either.
Now it's De Jong. Well, nowhere near. It was a long way out.
Yeah, I think that's... a waste to try his luck from there.
Two new faces about to be introduced here. Is a cheap piece of play to give the ball away like that. good piece of defending to stop the supply into the centre. Put the corner in the middle. Tries to punch it away. He's reached up and turned it over.
It will be a corner again.
In goes the corner. The shot is blocked. Corner played in and turned away by the goalkeeper spectacularly.
So the referee awards goal. Now it's De Jong. Striding forward purposefully.
Must take the lead here. It's a wonderful display by the goalkeeper today, and he's kept the team in the match. The score's still level.
Well, that should give his teammates a lot of heart that maybe they can go on and win this.
Only partially cleared, so there's still some problems for them. Could have been difficult, but the defender sorted it out.
Official has indicated
referee's had a good look and decided what he's seen from this period of play to add on 3 minutes. One eye on the clock as Newcastle go forward. Time's running out on them. Now the possibility for a cross. Well, it is a chance to relieve some of the pressure here by simply having the ball. Very good positioning by the defender. And that is the final whistle from the referee. The teams are level here. Really exciting here. And the two teams have been at each other, hammer and tongs, but they've ended level.
Yeah, coming into the match, I found it difficult to separate them, and that's how it's turned out at the end.
Just a couple of questions for you. Thank you.
Thank you for joining us here today. We'll be taking some questions now. Thank you for joining us here today, guys. That's all we have time for.
Well, this is the kind of match every football fan looks forward to. A lot on the line and the likelihood of a tension-packed occasion. We have all the action for you live on EA TV. And we are ready to go, just about. Millions of viewers from all around the world are tuning in for the Super Cup decider. My name is Derek Ray here on the commentary position. I'm joined by Lee Dixon. And with the atmosphere building to fever pitch, we're inching ever closer to kickoff time. It's Atletico Madrid up against Newcastle United.
Well, the Super Cup final reward for the two teams that win the major trophies in Europe, the Europa League and the Champions League, match off tonight. I'm really looking forward to this one, Derek.
Starters for Atletico. Jan Oblak starts in goal. Manuel Akanji plays alongside Jose Maria Jimenez in central defence. Piotr Zielinski plays with Yuri Tielemans in the centre of midfield. And the story in attack is one of a strike partnership. So the starting 11 for Newcastle United. And the positioning of the forwards particularly interesting.
Yes, Derek, a four at the back and a conventional four across the midfield. But the two up front is what I'm looking at. It will become a one with a one behind, and that one behind will be playing in the Teddy Sheringham role.
In the battle for the UEFA Super Cup, they're underway now. Space on the flank. Now he must favour the cross. Surely not far away at all with the volley.
Well, to catch it like that, you've got to have really good technique, and oh, so close.
A Jose Perez. Definitely look as though they want to make this move count. Well, that's one for them to pursue. Really top-class goalkeeping from Jan Oblak. And he's fired over the corner. The fist of the goalkeeper. Saint-Maximin, not the easiest of situations for the keeper. And it's gone behind for the corner. Over it comes, punching it clear. Authoritative challenge. Saint-Maximin. Longstaff. Jota. It might be the moment to get them ahead. Serious miscue. He's given it straight to the opposition. Well, they have the ball once more. It should be the first goal of the match, and the lead certainly doesn't flatter them.
It's taken a while, but the pressure's taken its toll. Well, just look at the keeper. He thinks it's coming out. Have another look. It's in the back of the net. He's a little bit unlucky.
Let's go back to the goal that was scored.
Newcastle, Well, the manager's showing signs of frustration. They need to improve if they're going to get something out of this game, Derek.
The opening goal of the game then. They counter clinically. And that was a very fine read. Well, they are on the wrong end of the scoreline. But Lee, your overall thoughts on their current situation?
Well, so far, I give Atletico six.
Can't miss, surely. And there it is, the goal they wanted for security. They lead by two now. They can breathe that bit more easily.
Well, they say there's no better time to score just before half-time. Team talk to both sides are going to be changing now. It's a good finish, Derek, and they deserve the lead.
Second goal for them here. We've been waiting to find out. Now we know, a minimum of three added minutes here. Gomez. Correa. Mbabu. Now Correa. So half-time it is in this battle for Super Cup supremacy. One team excelling, the other flounderingly.
Well, it won't happen, Derek, but one team could take players off and rest them and the other team needs to put three or four more on. It really is that lopsided. We need a bit more pride and passion. Let's see if we see it in the second half.
Tielemans. Teammates could potentially join in. João Félix. Oh, that's an interesting pass. Still possibility. And a goal for Atletico Madrid.
Well, they inflict a lot of pressure on the opposition, and that time the opposition couldn't cope with it. Well, it's a great goal. A real class finish. You don't see goals scored like this very often.
Slightly different vantage point in terms of the goal that was scored. They kick off again. 2-1 the current state of affairs. James Maddison. Half an hour remaining then. De Jong. Just not looking confident in possession. Correa. That's a go. A piece of goalkeeping you're going to see again and again and again. And firing it into the area. Not all that convincing defensively. Oh, a fine block. Played into the centre. Gets his glove on it. Crossing possibilities. Hans. Lozano now. Gomez. Crossed accurately towards the far post. high degree of difficulty to hit it on the volley like that, and it was close.
Well, it's all about timing. You've got to wait for the ball to come down, and he's very, very unlucky.
The electronic board has been held aloft. 2 additional minutes here. And possession lost, intercepted. And full time, most satisfying, a victory in the curtain raiser to the season.
Well, a trophy, Derek, is a trophy, and they've deserved that today, played very well. They won't mind its pre-season at all.
Not in the slightest. First piece of silverware, and that is never to be sniffed at, as the players applaud the fans who've been backing them today.
Yeah, it's always nice, Derek, it really is. But I think the players are more concentrated on their fitness levels in this game.
Now for the trophy lift. And the players always savour these moments.
The fans are enjoying it. They'll be looking forward to 9 months' time when they're picking up a big one.
That is certainly the hope. Get to relax a bit and enjoy having the pictures taken.
Well, you know exactly where I'd be sitting in that photo, don't you, Derek?
I think I've heard it before, Lee.
Straight at the front.
Time for just a few questions. Thanks very much.